Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to program a unique feature on the 5808W3 wireless smoke and heat detector. So we've already shown you in a prior video how to program this sensor to detect on high heat or rapid heat changes in the room, as well as smoke detection in the room. That will protect you for life safety fire issues. However, this device is unique. And using a separate loop and the same serial number, you actually can use this sensor to detect low temperature as well. So because it's got the ability to sense temperature for the high heat, we can also get an alert if it gets too cold in the room. So if it gets approaching 43 degrees, you can actually have it set off an alarm to let you know that, hey, it's a pre-freeze condition. We're approaching the temperatures where pipes can freeze and you can have real serious issues in the house, burst pipes and flooding and stuff like that. So, this is a great sensor for getting multiple uses out of it. Not only can you get that life safety protection, but now you're getting some environmental protection as well. So, we're going to show you how to program it now. We've already installed our battery because we did just program the smoke and the heat portion of this sensor. And so what we're going to do is show you how to program the low temp zone. So if we do security, tools, and type our installer code, for our purposes, we've left it default 4112. Now we hit save on this screen. This screen is only displayed if you're not yet monitored. Once you're monitored, your account's been associated with the cloud or with AlarmNet servers, and this screen isn't showing. But because this system has not yet been associated, it's trying to get associated. We're just going to say no. And now we're on the normal screen. If you were monitored, as soon as you hit program, or as soon as you hit your installer code, you would have this program option. And when you hit program, you can go to zones, and now we can program our low temp zone. You can see we have zone 1 and 2. Those are the hardwired zones. We're not using those. Zones 3 through 5 are template zones for the wireless sensors you would most likely use. And then we have our upstairs smoke detector, which is this smoke detector device. To do the temperature zone, we have to set up a second zone with the same serial number. And to do that, we highlight zone 8 and click edit. And we click into the serial number box and we open it up to see what serial number this sensor has. So it's very difficult to fault the temperature sensor, you know, put it into 43 degrees. So the normal way where we suggest auto-enrolling it won't really work for the smoke detector. But if you put in the serial number manually and hit done, you can see it learned it in. If we try to save the message now, or save the parameters now, we're going to get an error message. Duplicate serial or loop number. That lets you know you've made a mistake. And the reason it gave us that error is because for the smoke in the actual fire zone, the smoke and heat zone that we programmed on zone 7, we're using this serial number loop number combination. And you cannot have the same exact serial number and the same exact loop number on more than one zone. It's impossible. You get that error if you try to do it. However, we've read our installation guide for our 5808W3, and we know that when we select loop number 3, then this serial number will report low temperature activations. And that's the way you do it. So you use the loop number to tell the system what alarm event did this detector select or detect. If it detects fire and heat, it reports on zone 7 because that's loop number 1. If it reports a low temperature, it's because it saw on loop number 3 a low temperature alert in the room. So for device type, instead of choosing smoke detector, which yes, it is a smoke detector, but it's the special temperature portion of the smoke detector. So instead of smoke detector for the device type, we choose temperature, and it chose the most popular response type for temperature, which is 24-hour auxiliary. And with it set to that method or that response type, the local device will make a noise, and the panel will make a siren sound, but it's not a full siren sound. So it's not a full burglary alarm sounder. It'll just give you a beeping in the house to let you know, hey, there's an event. And if you have Total Connect, that can go out as a text message. So if you're not home you know, maybe the police aren't rushing over because your pipes are going to burst, but you can get neighbors to come check on the house and, you know, fix the furnace or do whatever's needed to do to fix the problem of the low temp. So we always suggest 24-hour aux. And if you want to name it, we know we have this in our living room. I'm sorry, we have this upstairs. So if we put the letter U, it jumps to the word up. We like to say a little better than just up or upper. So we do upstairs. And when we save it, because the smoke detector was learned in upstairs, and this is the same smoke detector that's going to be giving us our low temp alerts, we're just going to call it upstairs temperature. And we know we could even call it freeze. So an F and an R, we can say upstairs freeze temperature to let us know exactly what this alarm event means. Alarm report is, do we want this to go to the central station or not? In this case, yes, we're monitored. We want it to report. If we wanted just a local noise in the house and not go to the central station, you could select no. Chime, you are able to put a chime on there, but on a temperature sensor like this, which is a 24-hour zone, it's not really a zone that faults like a door opens and closes. You don't really need a chime for this type of sensor. And then supervision. We always want to make it supervised. That way we know if the device has a low battery or is out of range. Because this sensor is now programmed to two different zones, if they are both supervised, you would get alerts on both zones when there's an issue. So if we had a low battery, it would report on zone 7 and 8. So if you wanted, you could select that to be unsupervised and just trust that the zone 7 we have programmed for the smoke and the heat would handle all of your supervision. But no problem. We understand what our device is, so no problem to have them both set supervised. And now we can see upstairs freeze temperature here. And if we come back to the home screen, it's difficult to demonstrate a low temperature on video here, but what we can do is activate the test switch on the device. So the test switch is this hole, or it's actually at the base of this hole, opposite the hole with the plastic bridge. And when we were programmed just with the smoke and heat and we activated the device, we had a fire alarm showing on zone 7. Now when we do the test switch, we're going to show you both zones 7 and 8 are in alarm mode. So we press and hold. We can see fire alarm 7. And we can see alarm 8 upstairs. So because both zones are programmed, setting off the test button sets off both zones. If we go and we look at the zones, we can see the alarm has been canceled, but because we haven't disarmed a second time, both sensors are still showing activated. And if we clear alarms by typing our code again, now we're back to ready to arm. And now we know we've properly programmed our 5808W3 smoke and heat detector for our low temp freeze condition. So that's a really great feature. A lot of people don't realize they have a detector in their house that can do that kind of low temp sensing. So if you do have one of these sensors, we recommend you program that extra loop number 3 to get that extra value out of your sensor. So we hope you've enjoyed that video on how to program your 5808W3 low temp zone to your Honeywell Lyric panel. If you have any questions on how that low temp sensing works or how to program your 5808W3, please email us support@alarmgrid.com and make sure to subscribe to our channel so you're kept up to date on all the great new videos that we'll be releasing around this Honeywell Lyric new all-in-one wireless security system.